Welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss about very important long answer in data communications, that is ISO OSI model and its layers. Okay, ISO OSI. ISO stands for International Standard Organization. It is an organization which denotes the standards of the networks. Okay, networks and other products. OSI is a model, okay? It is a model. OSI stands for Open System Interconnection, okay? OSI is developed in late 1970s, okay? It was introduced in late 1970s, okay? OSI model is used for transferring of the information from one device to another device irrespective of the underlying architecture. That means without considering the underlying architecture, like without considering the architecture of a device, we can transfer the information from one device to another device with the help of OSI. Okay, and coming to the OSI layers, there are 7 layers in ISO OSI model. They are application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. These are the 7 ISO OSI layers which are very important and basic. Okay, now let us see what is the architecture of the ISO OSI model. Okay, coming to the architecture is like this. These are the 7 layers. And these are the 7 layers of another device. Okay, this is the 7 layers of device A, and these are the 7 layers of device A and B. Okay, and in between these devices, there will be the intermediary nodes. This is computer A. This is computer B. Okay. In between these systems, there will be intermediary nodes. Okay. This acts as an interface between the computer A and computer B. Okay. And in between the layers of the single device, there will be interface. See, this is application layer, this is presentation layer, this is session layer, this is transport layer, this is network layer, this is data link layer, and this is physical layer. Okay. In between all these devices, there should be a connection. That connection is known as interface. That connection is known as interface. Okay, in between every device, there will be an interface. Okay, and from physical device of physical layer of device A to physical layer of device B, there will be a intermediary nodes again. Okay, and again there will be the interface between the layers of device B. Why this interface? Means the interface is used to transfer the data or the information from one layer to another layer. I will explain you how. If there are two devices without a connection, we can't transfer the information. Okay, so this connection is an interface. It is called an interface in this model. Okay, and coming to this, I'll explain you why is this. This is called the transmission medium. This connection is called transmission medium. Transmission medium It provides the physical transmission between the physical layers of device A and B, and the work of physical layer is physical layer C. Generally, the computer A will send the information in the form of data, but we all know that inside the architecture of the computer, data cannot be understood. It should be converted in the form of bits. Okay, bits means 0101, like that. So once it reaches to physical layer, there will be data, the same data which computer A sent to physical layer, like this. See, I'll say you first, computer A will send the information to application layer. With the help of this interface, the application layer will send the same information to presentation layer. With the help of this interface, the same data will be transferred to session layer. In the same way, data link layer will transfer the same data to physical layer. Okay, so the data is available now in physical layer, but the physical layer cannot send the data to the device B, physical layer in the device B directly, because we cannot transfer the data as it is from one device to another device, because the computer cannot understand the data, it can just understand the bits. So physical layer will convert the data into bits. Okay, now the bits will be transferred to this data, and those bits will again be converted into data. Okay, see, now here the data is in the form of bits. Here the physical layer will receive the data in the form of bits, and those bits again will be converted into data and will be sent to the data link layer, and those data with the help of interface it will be sent to network layer. In the same way, it will reach to computer B. So computer B will receive the same data which computer A wants to send. Okay, this is the architecture of the ISO OSI model. Okay, now let us see what are the layers and what are the work done by the ISO OSI layer. Okay, now let us discuss in detail about this. Okay, now first layer, which is most important layer, is called physical layer. Actually, I'll tell you one thing, I said you there are 7 layers, right? 1, 2, 3, okay, 7 layers, right? This is application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. This is the 7 layers diagram. Okay, but the counting sequence of the diagram will not be like this. This will be the first layer, this will be the second layer, third layer, fourth layer, fifth, sixth, and seventh. Okay, so we should we should start counting the layers from bottom. So first layer will be the physical layer. The physical layer is the layer which will convert the task of the physical layer. Now let us discuss. Okay, physical layer task is to convert the data into bits. Okay, this is the task of the physical layer. Okay, and it lays the transmission medium between the devices. Transmission medium between devices means, I'll explain you. See, this is the physical device of a physical layer of device A, and this is the physical device of a physical layer of device B. there should be a transmission medium between these two devices in order to transfer the information from one device to another device. So physical layer provides that transmission medium, okay? So this is the task which is done by the physical layer. And now let us see what are the other characteristics and what are the other things which are done by the physical layer, okay? The first one is, it provides transmission medium. Second one is, it converts the data into bits, okay? It converts the data into bits. And next is, it provides the topology, physical topology. I have done a video on topology, so check out that video in my channel. Topology, roughly I'll explain you now. Topology means, it explains the representation, it explains the representation between devices and links. I'll say you, if there are two devices and these two devices are linked, the topology explains the relationship between these devices and the links, okay? This is only known as topology. Now next layer is data link layer. Task is frames or framing. Is nothing but the data divides the data will divide the bits into frames. See, I'll explain you what is framing. Framing means, see, if this is total data which is available, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, data link layer will divide the data into frames. This is frame 1. This is frame 2. This is frame 3. Like this. So that it will be so easy to transfer the information from one layer to another layer. So data link layer will divide the bits into frames, okay? So it is called as framing, okay? And second one is flow control. The task which is done by data link layer is flow control. Flow control means, if there are two devices or two layers, this is sending device and this is receiving device, okay? If the sending speed of the device A is 50 words per second and if the receiving device B speed is only 20 words per second, the remaining data will be lost because it is not capable of receiving the data in the same speed of sending device. It is sending fastly and it is receiving slowly, so the data will be lost. So there should be a flow control. Like, the data link layer will control the flow of the data from one device to another device, okay? And the next layer is network layer, okay? Network layer, the name itself is explaining. It explains about the network of the devices. Network of the device means, the network layer takes the responsibility to transfer the data successfully from source to destination. Source means the device which is the place at which the data is starting, okay? Example, I'll say you, this is device A and this is device B. This is sending device and this is receiving device. Okay, then this will be the destination, because this is a place or device where the data needs to be received. So this is destination, this is the final destination. This is the final destination and this is source, because from this source only the data is starting to send. Okay, so this is called network layer. And next is transport layer. Coming to transport layer, see, it is similar to network layer. Network layer will concentrate on transfer of the data from source to destination, whereas transport layer will concentrate on delivery of the data from one process to another process. From one process to another process. That means if there are many processes in the architecture, from this process to this process, delivery of the data will be looked out by transport layer. Okay, it makes sure that the delivery of the data is done successfully from one process to another process. This is the task of the transport layer. Okay, and another task of the transport layer is segmentation and reassembly. Segmentation and reassembly means this is the data available. Okay, first it segments the data. Okay, this is device A and this is device A and this is device B. While sending the data will be segmented into parts, and after reaching to final destination, all the segmented parts will be again reassembled. Okay, again reassembled into original data. This is the task done by the transport layer. Next is session layer. Session layer means session layer concentrates on the synchronization. That is, it looks after the device A and device B, that is the sending device and receiving device. Sending device and receiving device has a synchronization. Means if the sending device speed is 80 words per second and receiving device is 20 words per second, it means that there is no synchronization, because sending device speed is more than receiving device. So there is no synchronization. So now we should establish the synchronization between sending device and receiving device. This task is done by the session layer. Okay, and the last and final layer, last second layer, is known as presentation layer. Presentation layer. It concerns, means it looks after the information which is exchanged between two systems. Okay, see, between two systems. Okay, I'll explain you what is this presentation layer. Okay, normally when there are two systems, when there are system A and system B, the information will be transferred from one system to another system, right? So that information will be exchanged between two systems with the help of presentation layer. And the presentation layer will also look after the syntax of the layer. That is, it takes care that the data which is sent by the system A is in the format which is acceptable by the system B. Example, if system B accepts only bits, then with the help of presentation layer, we will convert the data into bits so that the system B can easily accept the data because it is in the same format, which is easily acceptable by the system B. This work is done by the presentation layer, and other few tasks which are done by the presentation layer is encryption. Encryption means changing the data format from the readable form to unreadable form, okay, so that there will be a security and privacy to the data. There will be no hackers then, okay. This is called encryption. And compression also will be done by the presentation layer. Compression means if there is 50 MB of data, it reduces to 25 MB of data. Means it reduces the store the length of the data, so that we can save the storage capacity, storage memory of the system, okay. And the last device is called last layer is called application layer. Is very easy. Application layer is nothing but it helps in file transfer. It helps in file transfer and it provides mail services. These are the tasks which are done by all the 7 OSI ISO model layers. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get future notifications of the video of my channels. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel.